Hey guys, my name is Moon, and welcome back for more Umineko When They Cry, Episode 2. So, last time, we had another conversation, right, with Kanon, talking about furniture, yet again. His favorite word, being furniture. So, we are with Shannon right now, and I guess this is gonna be good, right? With what they were talking about, with Kanon and Shannon talking about Beatrice. This is gonna be good. Okay, she's here with Beatrice now. Shannon entered the VIP room, bowing her head and pushing the serving cart. The young woman by the window, gazing out in the supposedly empty darkness, was definitely that witch. But they should have written, right? Back then when we were seeing the scenes with Shannon, with George, with Beatrice here, what date it was, right? They didn't even say, like, oh, it was a couple months ago. Oh, it was a year ago. There was no date there, right? It was just, yeah, all of the things happening without a date, so we don't really know how long has it been since Shannon saw Beatrice again, right? It could have been, last time I saw her, it could have been like 2 years ago, right? But no, there was nothing like that.
Kanon-とは違うな. 見違えたぞ.
ありがとうございます.
Shannon solemnly prepared dinner. There were actually several things she wanted to ask the witch. But they were all jumbled up and she didn't know where to start. Her heart was also jumbled up and she didn't even understand her own emotions. So she could only do her job dispassionately with everything still vague. However, the witch saw what was in her heart. You can't hide anything from a witch.
謝らぬぞ. わらわは魔女だからな.
何がでしょう。ほうや。カノンから聞かされたであろう。そなたの恋路を助けたのはわらわの単なるいたずら心。いかにして恋路で、ねじれ、破綻するかを干渉するために蒔いた種に過ぎぬと。恋はするより聞く方が楽しいかとも折られるでしょう。
まさか、わらわに感謝しようというのではあるまいな。はい。あなたが私にどんな下心があって恋の魔法を授けたとしても、あなたが私に与えてくれたものは変わらない。だから、添い遂げられないと知りつつ蒔いた種であったとしても、
私は恨んだりしません。ふん。やはり家具というのは面白みのない。それを面白く調理するのがわらわの腕の見せ所よの。私にベアトリーチェ様のお考えは分かりません。 あなたは私たちなど足元にも及ばない大魔女で、その遠大な資料など想像するにも至りません。でも一つだけ言えることがある。なんだ。私に人間を教えてくれてありがとう。あなたが言った、私はもう 家具じゃない。
Thank you for teaching me to be human. Yeah, Shannon is still grateful, though.
黙れ, Kagu.
And it's kind of ticking off Beatrice here. Look at her. Look, she's sweating right now. She's pretty annoyed with what Shannon is saying.
真の人間ならば、婚約指輪を受け取ろうという日に告げられた死の宣告に嘆き狂いて踊り出すだろう。 なのにそなたは何だ。達観し、すべてを受け入れたような顔つきではないか。実に拍子抜けだぞ、カーグ。
いいえ、私はカグじゃない。
黙れカグ。
黙りません、カグではありませんから。
わらわの命令が聞けぬというか。
カグなら命令に従います。でも人間は命令に従うかどうかを自分で決めます。だから私はあなたの命令に従わない。
I won't obey your orders. Look at his face.
前言を撤回する。やはり面白いぞ。種をまかねば、そなたは何の感情も抱かず儀式に身を任せただろう。しかし今のそなたは実に面白く育ち、わらわを心底楽しませてくれるぞ。それでいい。わらわは退屈を愛さないのだから。
お夕食の準備が整いました。どうぞ。
うん、なかなかうまそうではないか。ゴーダが黄金郷へたどり着くことがあれば、わらわの料理長に任命してやってもよかろう。
カノン君に聞きました。私にジョージさんの婚約を断らせれば、私を生贄にしないなんて約束をしたとか。
うん、したぞ。そなたは第二の番にうってつけの生贄候補だったのだがな。
Okay, what is she gonna say here now? I mean, she's saying, yeah, you would make an ideal potential sacrifice for the second Twilight, which is true though, yeah. Both of them, her and George, right?
カノンがそれを許せと泣いて叫ぶので、寛大に聞き入れてやったのよ。
But yeah, who else though? Like, there's no one else right now, right? I mean, if you go by the first episode, right? It was Hideyoshi and Eva, right? Who else? Like, there's literally no one else. If they do that, it's gonna be repetitive, right? We'll see. Okay, we'll find. We'll just find out, I guess
そなたが婚約を破棄すればとの条件付きでな。わらわのなんと寛大なことよ。
なんてバカな条件、そしてなんてバカな脅迫。そんなものでカノン君をいじめ抜いたというの。
But maybe Kyrie and Rudolph, I mean, yeah, they can be, right?But we don't really have a lot of scenes with them, so... I don't think so, right? Because, yeah, the second Twilight was much more... Like, we see the characters being much more intimate to each other, right? And we, having a lot of scenes as well, is what I'm saying, right? We'll see.
Ho? Wakaru no ka?
Apparently, Shannon had the scene through it.She had apparently guessed at how the witch had bullied and humiliated Kano, and with that horrible promise as a bait.
絨毯に這いつくばらせ、わらわの靴にキスをさせてやったぞ。それだけではない。他にどのような恥ずかしめを与えたか、
Jesus.
聞きたいか。
Like, she's making fun of him still. Shannon silently shook her head.
あなたという人を私はようやく理解しました。あなたは人をいじめ、惑わせ、困らせて、それを楽しみ、糧にしている。だからあなたに抵抗する唯一の方法がこれであると確信した。
なんだ。
あなたなんか知らない。私は私に与えられた運命を全うする。 だからあなたを面白がらせたりしない。
あなたなんか知らない。
The witch's feature is twisted in hatred for just an instant. It disappeared immediately. But the expression that briefly rose to her face was rare for the witch, whose malicious smile usually never faded for a second.
そういう抗い方もあるか。面白い。気に入った。殺してやる。お前の思い人と一緒にな。
それがあなたの決められた運命ならば、ご随意。
But hey, how do you face her though, right? But yeah, we actually haven't seen how the actual killings happens, right? So... Okay.
私はそれに怯えたり、逆らったりしません。これから起こる苛烈な運命が、あなたの意志によるものだなんて信じないから。私たち人間は未来に起こりうる運命など知らない。だからこそ最後の瞬間まで自分の信念と運命に従い精一杯生き抜く。運命はただのサイコロの目、そこに悪意なんて感じない。あなたが吹き込もうと信じない。
ほう、家具をやめたくせに死を恐れぬとはな。それがわらわを退屈させると思っているようだが、それは大きな誤解だぞ。そなたが本当に最後の瞬間までそれを貫けるか、ますます興味が湧いた。
私は悔しい。どうしてあなたは人の姿をして私たちの前に現れ、人の言葉で語り私たちを嘲笑うのか。私たちの前に現れず運命を予告しなかったなら、私たちは最後の一瞬まで精一杯生きられるのに。
それが魔女というものよ。貴様らの運命を食い物に、工事の存在として定時の存在の上に君臨する。そなたらの運命など所詮はかけら。両手で椀を作ればいくらでも救える。わらわに飼われた肉牛どもが何をほざこうとも、わらわの食卓を楽しませる結果に変わりはせぬのに同じこと。
無力な私たちには、あなたの儀式にも運命にも抗うことなどできない。しかしあなたに、今すぐ不愉快な思いをさせることはできる。
So the only thing Shannon can do is I can make you unhappy right now before the ceremony starts and they all just die, right?
ほう、それは何か。
今すぐここを立ち去ることです。
By walking away from this place right now.
あなたの言葉に答えることは、すべてあなたを楽しませている。あなたの問いかけに答えないことが、あなたへ唯一できる抵抗です。
I guess, yeah. I mean, she was getting ticked off earlier, right? When Shannon was actually being, what do you call this? She was saying, I thank you for making me a human, something like that, right? And Beatrice was like, what?
なるほどなるほど。一矢報いることはできよう。しかしわらわを倒すことはできぬぞ。わらわは誰しもを永遠に殺す力を持っている。永遠に繰り返し殺される輪廻の中で、そなたがいつまでその抵抗をできるのか、実に楽しみだ。忘れるなよ。自らが口にした言葉。
それでは失礼いたします。ご用がありましたらお呼びください。
Shannon gave a reserved bow and faced away. With that gesture, maybe she really did take a shot back at the witch, just as Beatrice had said. Because when the witch called out again, she sounded a little more quick-tempered than she had before.
カノンはわらわに感謝したぞ。そなたは感謝せぬのか。安息の日をわらわが与えること。
I mean, she did thank you earlier, though, for helping her, right? Find love and to be human.
カグなら安息の日を喜びましょう。ですが、私は人間ですので。だから、あなたに感謝することはありません。ご用はそれだけですか？
ジョージから指輪をもらうつもりであろう。受け取れば、わらわがカノンと交わしたそなたを生贄に選ばないという約束を破棄すること、忘れるな。
まだご用があるなら他のものを来させますので、それでは失礼いたします。
A flat out interruption. Shannon still hadn't answered her, and the sound of the door closing came instead of an answer. I mean, yeah, this is Shannon's offensive, what do you call this? Offensive attack to Beatrice. Just ignore her, right? Basically. And look at Beatrice here. Like, Shannon did not hurt her physically, but she got really annoyed here. Look at that face. Shannon's resistance probably struck far more deeply into the witch than Shannon herself thought. Because an expression of hatred once again rose to Beatrice's face. She made Kanon submit even though he hadn't been ensnared until the end. Where Arias Shannon, who had been so easily ensnared before, refused to submit this time.
Nanda. Yahari, kore wa omoshiroi koto dewa nai ka? わらわもまだまだ若いか。これだから千年は生き飽きぬのよ。
Okay, where do we go next? This was most fabulous part of the family conference. This was the most fabulous part of the family conference. Dinner. In the past, when Kinzo had been serious about the conference, he'd taken everyone's yearly gathering for dinner very seriously. Because nothing embarrassing that occurred during dinner would cause the deepest shame for him as the host, he had given Natsu stern orders to avoid embarrassment at all costs. Because of that, she and Kraus eventually hired Goda, who had confidence in his cooking abilities. Thanks to that, they became able to serve wonderful dinners they could be confident in. They became able to serve? What is happening with the script right now? But by the time, Kinzo had closed himself up in his study and never appeared for dinner. Maybe you could call that ironic. When the main dish for tonight, a calf steak, was set out, Goda began to describe it proudly, further stimulating everyone's appetites.
こちら、ソースはボルドレーズとなっております。ベースの赤ワインはもちろん、ボルドー産の中でも素晴らしいものを使用しておりますが、その他にも当家オリジナルブレンドとしまして、世界各地数種類の名酒をブレンドしまして、より深い味わいとなりますよう整えてございます。
Honestly though, Goda has a face, right? Like whenever you see like anime characters that will do anything, right? To get something. Yeah, he has that face. Like, look at this.
このソースは本年限りのものでございます。
But this dude is definitely gonna die again, though. For sure. Right? But I don't think he's gonna be part of the six, I guess, initially. Like, in this one. When we start doing the ceremony, right? The first Twilight. I doubt he would. He was part of it in the first episode, but yeah, I guess he will die in the other Twilights for sure. Eh.
どうかお楽しみいただければ幸いです。
素晴らしいじゃないか。
素晴らしい。
しかし、ボルドレーズソースはフランス料理の王道ではないのかね。それに、フランス以外の酒を使うのは少し邪道ではないかという気もするね。
旦那様、本日は年に一度の親族会議でございます。普段は遠方にお住まいの皆様がはるばるお越しになり、一堂に集われた夜の晩餐には世界各地より普段は出会うことのない名酒を取り寄せブレンドしたソースが何よりもふさわしいかと存じ、特別にご用意させていただいたのでございます。
素晴らしい。本当に素晴らしい料理人や。あんたは能楽が変わると料理も薬も効果は2倍になるっちゅうわけやな。元の料理のうまさも2倍、さらに能楽で2倍、味の倍倍ゲームや。
いやね、兄さん、その質問読まれてたんじゃないの？
違いねえな。まんまと美味しいところをゴーダさんに持ってかれちまったぜ。
そうかね。今日の料理をフランス風だと気づいていない者もいるんじゃないかと思ってね。エヴァは先ほどバターを使わないのが美徳と言ったが、それはスペイン風だ。確かに国境を接してはいるがね。
そういう意味で言ったんじゃないわよ。話の一部分だけ抜き出して勝手に加工しないでくれるかしら。
とっても美味しいソースね。ゴーダさんは本当に素晴らしいわ。
お褒めに預かり大変光栄です。これもすべて奥様の日頃のご指導のおかげでございます。
いえ、すべてゴーダのアイディアです。私はレシピを聞き承認しただけです。
Okay, Gouda had his moment there. People talking about his food, right? It was nice. It looked like the siblings quickly got into a loud argument about the sauce. But for the most part, the dinner proceeded peacefully. However, a certain question they desperately wanted to ask burned inside each one of them. I'm guessing where is, grandfather? No, where is, father? Where is Kinzo?It was about the visitor, the 19th person. Okay, I guess. The Golden Witch. In actuality, Eva and Rudolph and the rest were very much under guards during this meal. If the mystery guest was ever going to be introduced, this dinner would be the most appropriate place to do it. But yeah, she had her food delivered to the room though, right? However, no place was set at the dinner table for the witch.The family conference would begin in earnest after the meal, and the previous experiences told them that it might last until deep into the night. However, they couldn't imagine why such a person should be kept hidden until that late if they were going to be introduced in the end anyway. Oh, we got this theme song again. This music. So Eva and Rudolph and the rest were starting to feel a certain suspicion.Perhaps this guest was unknown even to Kraus. If this wasn't an assassin called by Kraus to give him an advantage in the inheritance problem, then maybe they should speak frankly to Kraus beforehand, creating a common front to resist anything disadvantageous to the four siblings. If she was Kinzo's assassin, whose purpose was to keep the inheritance from being handed over to the four siblings, the enmity between Kraus and the other siblings could only become a weak point that benefited the enemy.
それではごゆっくりお楽しみください。
When he finished explaining the reasoning behind the table setting and the cooking, Gota tried to leave the room, but Kirie called him to a stop with a small voice.
はい、キリエ様。何か？
ごめんなさい。今日はお客様がいらっしゃってると思ったんだけど、晩餐にはお見えにならないのかしら？
She had planned on saying it nonchalantly, but unfortunately it reached the ears of Natsui, who was sitting in the next seat over. It seemed that Natsui had heard it, as even though the guests are here, why hasn't the host come to dinner? In other words, that Kirie had asked whether Kinzo was going to join them for dinner.
当主様は体調が優れられませんので、お部屋で食事をとると仰せです。主人が初めにそう説明いたしましたが、何か。ごめんなさい。そうじゃないの。
Natsui's reaction instantly told Kirie that this unknown visitor was also unknown to Kraus and his wife, which meant...On the chessboard inside Kirie's mind, she could hear the clattering of the pieces as they rearranged themselves.
Kaku?
Butler, who had been sitting next to Natsui, seemed to have heard Kirie's words without misunderstanding them, thinking it strange that someone else would be invited to today's family conference. He spoke up incredulously.And thanks to that, the uncomfortable feeling building in the siblings' chest suddenly exploded. Everyone looked at Gota at the same time. Judging by the reactions, it was clear that no one here had invited the mystery woman. For an instant, Gota was startled to find that everyone's gazes gathered on him, but because of his naturally vain personality, this actually gave him a feeling of superiority. He likes it, I guess.Therefore, he answered in an extreme calm and graceful manner. Like it's okay for him, I mean.
はい。貴賓室でお一人で食事を取られたいとのことで、そちらへお運びしております。
That extremely graceful and reasonable response of Goda's made it obvious to everyone that a 19th person, a visitor, existed.
貴賓室？客？何の？誰の話ですか?
Natsui's words echoed a question that everyone who didn't know about the appearance of the Golden Witch was thinking. For a while, Gota was disoriented, caught completely off guard by the sudden interrogation. This was a guest who had been treated with such deep respect. He hadn't imagined that Kraus and his wife might not even know about her.
その、ベアトリーチェ様でございます。
Here comes Maria, very excited yet again.
ほらほら! Beatrice, 来てるでしょ?
And then Rosa gonna smack her again. Maria had been telling the other cousins over and over again that she had met Beatrice that day. The cousins had answered flippantly, but they hadn't believed. So their eyes grew wide. I mean, when it's a kid, you're just gonna say, yes, yes, right?All the time, so they don't cry.
すまね。俺はてっきりマリアの冗談だと思ってたぜ。あ、本当にいたんだな。
ベアトリーチェって、あの黄金のベアトリーチェなのかよ。
ごめんね、マリアちゃん。そういうつもりじゃないんだよ。
After learning that everyone had doubted Beatrice's existence, Maria, who had been in a good mood all day, completely lost her temper. George, who sat in the next seat over, tried frantically to calm Maria down.
Gorda. それもディナーの何かの余興なのかね?なかなかの味な演出だ。
兄貴、三文芝居はやめようぜ。兄貴が呼んだんだろ。
呼ぶ?誰よ。どこから?
兄さん、はっきりさせましょ。あれは誰?まさか、本当に肖像画のベアトリーチェだと言うんじゃないでしょうね。
私にはお前たちが何を言っているのかさっぱりだ。ゴード、これは本当に冗談ではないのだな。
私はその…
I think the only one who knows though is Genji, I think, right? Or yeah, the servants, technically, right? Because, yeah, did Kinzo even know? I mean, if Kinzo knew, he'd be super excited, right? Beatrice, he's giving a lot of speeches about Beatrice and Beatrice being here, and he's not going outside. So I guess it means he still doesn't know that Beatrice is here, right? Only the servants know. But yeah, why didn't the servants tell Kinzo at least?
Genji-san からそのように指示を受けただけでして、その…
Genji を呼びなさい。今すぐ。
When Natsu yelled, Gouda sped out into the hallway. The sound of the door being thrown open was a spark that suddenly set the dinner table ablaze. You know what's funny? Because in the first episode, right, we were talking about, oh, is there a 19th person, right? They were giving all the stuff, them talking about it, and now there's an actual 19th person here. And she's in the VIP room.
呼んだのは誰だ?親父ってことか?
私には何のことかわからんね。お前たちは私が裏で糸を引いていると信じているようだが、それは大きな誤解だ。
クラス兄さん、落ち着いてえな。わしらはもう腹の探り合いをすべき段階にないで。もし兄さんも知らない怪人物だっちゅうなら、これはとんでもない話になるんやで。
秀吉さん、言葉を少し慎みませんか。主人は親族会議に不要な人間を招いたりはしません。
まったくだ。お前たちは何を言っているのかね。
I like whenever Kraus talks, he's like super confident in what he says, and he's always smiling, right? And smirking.
肖像画の魔女が額縁を抜け出して現れたとでも言うのかね。実際にその魔女様に会ったという人間がいるわけでもなかろうが。
私、会ったわ。
But yeah, here comes Rosa confirming it, right? And then maybe the Kiri a little bit later. Eva and Rudolph nodded at Rosa's proclamation.The brief tension was broken, and Maria also started to make a ruckus. By now, the room was already wrapped in chaos.
何が何だかさっぱりだぜ。つまり何だ?爺様に黄金を授けた魔女様が今年の親族会議にはスペシャルゲストとして登場ってわけかよ。
しかし、本当に?ローザおばさんの見間違いってことじゃねえの?ローザおばさん、間違いなくなんですか?
ええ、私とマリアは会って話もしてる。私は会ったの。あれは間違いなく魔女だった。信じて。私の見間違いとか錯覚とか、そんなのじゃ断じてない。あれは
What? In an instant before the typhoon arrived, Rosa definitely met a witch in the rose garden. But the scene had been so hard to accept as the truth that the more she spoke of it like this, the less she understood what it is or what it was she had encountered. Ironically, since she was losing her composure, the more frantically she tried to cling to her claim, the more confused and hazy the thing she was describing became. Because of that, it only took a single, calmly spoken sentence to confirm the nature of what she was describing beyond doubt.
私もあったわ。挨拶とはとても言えないけれど、一応言葉も交わしてる。ローザさんの見間違いとかじゃ断じてないわ。
キリエさん、それマジかよ。
ええ。でも彼女は私に名乗らなかった。だから彼女がベアトリーチェであると断定はできない。でも、主観的で恐縮なんだけど、私は玄関ホールで彼女に会ったから、肖像画と顔を見比べることができた。私は第一印象で、彼女こそがこの肖像画の主に違いないって思ったわ。あくまでも主観よ。
そんなことはありえません。第一、その女はどこからやってきたというのですか。今日の船は皆さんの送迎のための便が往復しただけです。その船に乗っていたのですか。
それを言われると弱いね。確かにそんなご婦人と一緒に下船した記憶はない。
あら、そう?
Here comes Ava. I mean, the way she talks all the time, man, I can't take her seriously.
私たちの乗ってきた船以外に船はないってどうして証明できるの?できないわ。来なかったわ、証明できない。
道理だな。来たは証明できる。来たのを見たやつが見たと言えばいい。しかし、来ないは証明できないぜ。全員が来ない、見てないと言ったところで、全員が見てないところでこっそり来たことを否定はできない。つまり、悪魔の証明ってやつだ。
It'd be simple to prove that devils exist. All you have to do is meet a devil, right? That easily.But it's impossible to prove that devils don't exist. Just by saying that no one has ever met a devil, you can't deny the possibility that they're hiding away somewhere humans can't go. You can't deny the existence of aliens for exactly the same reason. I mean, yeah. Until humanity searches the whole space and can show perfectly that aliens don't exist, you can't be sure that they don't exist.I mean, yeah, with arguments like this, yeah, this is true though, yeah. And it's definitely impossible for us to ever check the entirety of space for the existence of aliens. True as well. So basically, you cannot find an answer for that. Therefore, while there may be a number of ways to prove that aliens do exist, it will always be impossible to show proof that denies their existence.
となれば僕たちが乗ってきた船以外の船で来たかどうかなんて議論しても無駄な問題ということになるね。僕たちと一緒の船にはいなかった。それだけが事実で、それ以外の方法でとにかくこの島に訪れたことになる。
そうね。どうやって来たかなんて議論の必要はないかもしれない。肝心なのは現にこの屋敷に今いて、私たちと晩餐を共にする気がないという事実よ。
整理しよう。
Okay, let's do a review.
今この島には、後ろ宮家18人以外に、もう一人客がいる。
But it always bugs me though. Only 18 people in the whole island, right? You got a massive island. It's 10 kilometers wide, right? And there are no people on the dock. they have a beach here as well, right? Aren't there people there? Like checking or guarding it, right? Like you could get a boat and then someone could just, yeah, ride it to this island and you wouldn't know, right?
そしてそいつは兄貴も夏姫姉さんも知らない客だってんだな。
知りません。何の話だかも分かりません。
お前は少し黙っていなさい。頭痛に触る。妻の言う通りだ。私にはお前たちが何の話をしているのかさっきからさっぱりだ。
じゃあ答えは一つしかないわ。お父様が呼んだのよ。今日の親族会議のために。
Calm down, Eva. Calm down.
親族会議に？だから何のために？
そんなの知らないわよ。兄さんが知ってたらそれを問い詰めようって思ってたのよ。
Eva、予算か。
Yeah.
クラス兄さんは知らんと言うとる。つまり話はこうや。お父さんが肖像画の魔女にそっくりの客人をこっそり招いた。それにローザさんが出会い、マリアちゃんが出会い、そしてキリエさんも会った。今はそこまでや。わしらに言いたいことがあるんならとっとと姿を現せばええ。挨拶もなしに引きこもってるっちゅうんはどないなわけなんやってことな。
親族会議なんか花から関心のない親父が新しい愛人をこっそり呼びつけたってわけか。理想の魔女様のおべべを着せてよ。
I guess, yeah, you could argue. I mean, for us, we know that it is Beatrice there, right? But for them, they don't know? That is a good argument.
そう決着するには、今日という日は意味を持ちすぎてるぜ。
理由は一つしかない。親族会議に加わるためよ。
So they're seeing this new person as a threat, basically, yeah.
お父様の遺産について何かの権利を主張する気でいるのよ。
Yeah, threat to what is supposed to be theirs.
バカバカしい。当主様に愛人などと汚らわしいものなどおりません。
お前は黙っていると言っている。私はこの屋敷でずっと親父殿と過ごしているが、そんな話は聞いたこともない。最大限理解を示したとして、何十年も昔の愛人との間に隠し子がいたとして、それを親父殿が探し出し今日という日に呼びつけたと、こう言いたいのかね。
あなた、お父様にそんなものがいるわけがありません。尊い後宮の血が愛人ごときに。先ほどから数人が見た見たと自称しているにすぎません。幻想、妄想、白昼夢に決まっています。あるいはこれも夫を陥れるための皆さんの何らかの芝居なのですか。
何の芝居だってのよ。芝居だって言うならそっちでしょうが。
よせよ姉貴、ちょいと暴力的な言い方だが、夏日さんの言う通りではある。キリエは姿を見たが俺は見てない。姉貴もだ。だがローザは見た。しかしってことはいるってことになる。
But that means she exists.
いるを証明している連中が存在する以上、いるで直ちに決着だ。悪魔の証明の逆パターンってわけだな。それに俺も会いたいんだよ。そして一体当家に何の御用かと直接問いただしたい。
それについては私も同感だ。六軒島へ何の御用かぜひお尋ねしたいものだ。
しらじらしいこと言わないで。狙いは一つよ。お父様の遺産を狙ってるのよ。相続問題に明るい弁護士に今後の作戦を練らせるべきよ。 お母様と同格の権利を愛人が主張した場合、私たちの取り分はかっきり半分さらわれることになる。
ちょっとみんな待って。
Okay, why?
ゲンジさんがもうじき来るわ。
But yeah, honestly, they're not really... Like, even if the person was the witch, right? Like, it doesn't really matter. What really matters to them is...yeah, the money, the inheritance, everything will be cut because of this person. It don't matter if it's the Golden Witch. It don't matter if it's a mistress, right? It matters because the money they might get might be reduced because of this person being here. You can see Ava, right? She is shouting. She's being serious and angry because of that.
彼は何でも知ってる。きっと私たちの疑問に答えてくれるわ。それまでそういう話はなしにしましょう。さあ子供たち、悪いけれど大人はちょっと込み入った話をしないといけないの。
Oh, are we gonna see the conversation they had?
ゲストハウスへ戻っていなさい。
Rosa yelled at the children, slightly overcome with emotion. The children didn't understand why they were suddenly being yelled at this time, but Ava and the rest realized it too late.They were talking so bluntly about the filthy topic of the inheritance right in front of the children. Yeah. Of course, they wouldn't want their children to remain. So they all immediately agreed with Rosa's plan.
そうやな。ローザさんの言う通りや。ジョージ。
ジョージ。
いとこみんなでゲストハウスに戻ってるんや。いとこ同士、仲良く遊ぶんやで。
ジョージ、言われた通りになさい。いとこみんなを連れて今すぐ出ていくのよ。
ちょっと待ってよ母さん。僕たちはまだ食事も終えていない。
おお、デザートもまだ来てない。
デザート will be brought to you instead.
おお、
Don't worry.
デザートはゴーダさんにゲストハウスに運ばせます。だから出て行きなさい、ジェシカ。ここから先は大人の話し合いです。行きなさい。
わかったよ。まだ食いかけだってのによ。
ってことは、俺だけ例外ってことはないよな。
理解してくれてありがとう、バトラ君。でもあなたラッキーよ。
どうして？
私も出ていけるなら出ていきたいもの。
違いねえぜ。大人は大人で遺産をめぐって楽しい一家団らんをお楽しみくださいってんだ。
私も席を外しましょう。どうやら今夜は私の出番はなさそうだ。
Nanjo quietly rose to his feet. From his seat in the farthest corner, he had been calmly watching the whole discussion without butting in. Nanjo is just eating there, and then seeing all these people from the Ushirumiya family bicker about inheritance money, right? While Kinzo...is his friend and his patient, right? When Nanjo rose from his seat, it ended up encouraging the others who were supposed to leave. The children noisily rose from their seats, and as they hurried into the hallway, the servants returned.
遅くなって申し訳ございません。
Okay, here comes Goda and Genji.
Genji をお呼びいたしました。
お屋敷の中の戸締まりの確認に行っておりましたもので、遅くなりました。申し訳ございません。
さあ、子供たちはゲストハウスへ。ゴーダさん、申し訳ないのだけれど、子供たちの分のデザートをゲストハウスへ運んでくれるかしら。
は、よろしいのですか。
It seemed that Goda wasn't amused to see the dinner he'd worked so hard on.Interrupted like this. He sent Natsuhi a look as though asking her whether that was really okay.
ローザさんの言う通りにするように。それから私たちにデザートの配膳は不要です。呼び出しがあるまで食堂には近づかないように。これは他の使用人にも伝えること。いいですね？
あ、はい、かしこまりました。さあさあ皆さん参りましょうかな。マリアさんもこれ以上お母さんを困らせてはいけません。
マリアちゃん、僕たちにゲストハウスでベアトリーチェの話を聞かせてくれないかい？ぜひ魔女の話を聞きたいんだね。
はい、
ジョージ兄さんは本当にうめえぜ。感動するぜ。
本当に子持ちじゃねえのかよ。手慣れすぎだぜ。
George's words had completely restored Maria's good mood, and now she took the initiative telling the others to head on to the guest house. It looked like Goda didn't like being kicked out himself, but he couldn't disobey Natsu, so he left the room with Butler and the rest, closing the door.
ご用は何でしょうか、皆様。
あるわ、たっぷりと。それもみんな誰から質問するか、くじ引きが欲しいくらいよ。
だが誰が一番のくじを引こうとも最初にする質問は同じだと思うがね。
違いねえな。源氏さん、正直に答えてくれ。今貴賓室にいるベアトリーチェってのは何者なんだ？
お、it ended though. Okay. What time is it? 10 p.m. now. Wedding ring. Okay, but yeah, I do wish we could see that meeting though, right? With all of them talking about this. This was, we didn't see this last time, right? In episode 1, them having a meeting with inheritance and stuff like that. I want to see that. But yeah, anyways, we are going to continue this and do more of Mineko When They Cry episode 2 in the next one. So I'll just see you then, guys. Bye bye.